typical day here in the fifth grade math classroom. The kids come in, are used to their routine of the problem of the day and getting into their binders and some review work, some front load work, and starting to get into the things that we're going to tackle this week. And the kids are really accustomed to that, and they know that the weekly POD work turns into a quiz come Friday. That's a responsibility check of not only their learning and fixing, but of their correct answers as well. So being responsible for the POD, and then we were able to jump into our learning targets and get moving on a new lesson today and get into some practice of dividing decimals. The problem of the day, probably not as structured as what people may think. I kind of adapt to that of where I think our kids are at. So if we had work yesterday and we noticed some mistakes off of some type of assessment, we'll go back and correct that and try to go back to it. We also do the problem of the day with, there's part of our curriculum that falls on the back end of the year as far as our mapping, and we try to front load a lot of those things with like measurement, which we talked about today as one of the last things that we cover, but just feel it's important to get into that, and then also get some problems in there of what we are going to do today and the assessments that are coming up later in the week. So those are created every night or morning for that particular day. Today's learning target was the second one of the week already. We had a quick one yesterday, which was dividing decimals by powers of 10. And today was dividing decimals by a whole number. The kids are used to getting into their binders and look forward to a new learning target and something that they're able to master throughout the day, the week, and time to come. Our learning targets are posted on the whiteboard. It's kind of been something we've been adapting and trying to figure out what's best. We do have some small printouts around the room. Kids are able to refer to those. Students who are absent are able to go and visualize those and get caught up with their binders. And then we have those also on the smart board. So as you can see, when the kids and we go to the learning target, they know that they go to their binders, and each kid has a paper in there, kind of like a self-assessment, and they're able to write it in there, what we call our own language, breaking down from the state standard to kind of our team learning target, and even in the child's language or the student's language. So we have those hopefully posted in enough ways, and I think the accountability, having it in their binder, has really been helpful for us. Getting our students to talk about success criteria and learning targets has been a challenge. We have them posted on the board. As we said, we've done some different things, but being able to have them work in different manners of having them come to the board, having them work in small group, some teacher-led discussions, and they will get into some other resources and checks with our splash math, our accelerated math, diagnostics, book work, hoping that they are getting more accustomed to working and talking and feeling comfortable amongst each other, and having that posted on the front board so they can see it all the time and hopefully repeat it enough. And then also, whenever a student feels like they have accomplished and mastered this learning target, they go back to their binder and they get to do a little self-check in there, a little autograph star, whatever they do to feel the success of mastering that learning target. In the students' binders, we have several assessment checklists in there. Splash Math is a big resource that goes right in hand with our standards, our learning targets, our curriculum. So when they accomplish and get their full mastery of that skill, they go in and highlight that skill, which then we hope leads into their learning target page. They have a sheet in there that they write in our own language what the learning target is for that particular lesson, and then they're able to go into that sheet, which also has examples on there, reminders of what we're learning, and they're able to sign off, so to speak, that they have mastered that skill. A couple things we found to be very helpful to help our kids get through this and to better just understand the whole process. And now I think our kids, when we don't do it as often, or we had a unit we did more project-based and we kind of went away from the sheet, now they're feeling some accomplishment and some respect or some responsibility that they need to have this. So I think number one, having it in their language where they're helping to create it. Seen several other teachers in this building have done the same thing with using student language to create these. And that checklist in our binders and having the kids being able to refer to that and feeling that accomplishment has been very helpful for us.